Let's do it.
I'm testing out some different MIG welding settings today, and I'm going to do some cutting and etching and compare. Let's get right into it. For starters, I'm going to use a 1/4-inch thick metal on an outside corner joint, and I'm going to be using really low wire feed speed settings. Now, in motorsports, on an outside corner joint like this, on suspension parts and things like that, oftentimes people will turn the wire feed speed down pretty darn low, and it slows the travel speed down, and they use a little technique. It's kind of known as MIG-like TIG, and it makes a sort of a stack of dimes, and I'm not very good at it. But I'm using those similar settings anyway to what I've seen done from people that are good at it. And basically it's kind of like this, where you just kind of work the arc down into the bottom of the joint, just slowly progress, a little hitch forward, and then kind of back a little bit and pause. And it's a very slow travel speed, and when done right, it looks really super nice. Like I said, I am not good at this, and for some reason I just don't have the MIG-like TIG gene in me. But that's a similar technique anyway, and so now I'm going to go to the auto set function here, and this is what it tells me I should be using for 3/16-inch thick metal. Even though I'm welding 1/4-inch, I'm going to just use the default settings for 3/16, which are much higher. Like, the wire feed speed is 342 as opposed to 190. That's a lot of difference, and wire feed speed controls amperage. So all I'm doing here is just staying up in the front of the puddle and just doing a very slight oscillation, mostly just to play the light a little bit and help me see where I'm going a little bit better. But you can see the travel speed is quite a bit faster. I've got my stick out probably a little longer than I should, but that's mainly just for filming, so the nozzle doesn't block the arc. So, very different look. You can see there's definitely a difference in penetration. The one on the left is the colder one. The only way to really tell what happened is to cut into them, polish, cut, and etch. Then we can see exactly how much penetration we got or didn't get. Again, this is at 18.6 volts, 190 inches a minute, 035 wire. A swab etch will tell us exactly what we got here. You could already see a hint of lack of fusion there in the root of the joint, but now we know exactly how much we got. You won't always see lack of fusion before you etch. That's why you etch. All right, this is the hotter of the two, run at 342 inches a minute, 19.5 volts. We should see some difference here, but nothing like testing to make sure. That one got in there a whole lot better, definitely. Next, I'm going to turn it over, just slightly change the position. Instead of welding flat, this is horizontal. There's really not much different, but for some reason it did change the way the puddle flowed a little bit. So I'm using the stock settings here for 3/16 metal, and I'm trying to go slow enough that I make sure to nip that top corner but not undercut it. Travel speed is, I don't know, maybe it's a little slower, because I'm having to kind of really watch for undercut, whereas I didn't have to worry so much in the flat position. All right, next I'm going to go down and drop down again to those lower settings, the same settings I used before, the lower wire feed speed. And that makes the travel speed really go really slow. I'm pausing at the top and letting the puddle fill up and nip those edges so I don't have any choppy undercut, and I'm probably still going to have some. But this does slow the travel speed a lot. I'm working the arc to try to work the metal down into the root of the joint. But who knows? That's why we test stuff. So definitely not MIG-like TIG, but fairly uniform. It looks better, appearance-wise, than the hotter setting. You can see the hotter setting is on the right, definitely penetrated more. And since this is now the other side in a fillet weld, I can handle a lot more heat here. I'm going to crank it up to the recommended settings on the auto set, and basically you just select material thickness. So I've got 21 volts and 355 inches a minute. That's what it gave me when I selected 1/4-inch thick steel. Years ago, I would take in parts into my garage shop, and I would weld maybe, 30 or 50 parts that had 4 or 5 welds this long on them, and I would use probably a little bit hotter setting than this, just because it sped things up a lot, and I was interested in getting done with the job and getting paid. And that's what I would do. If the job can handle the heat, why not crank it up a little bit? So an inside corner like this, even though it's 3/16, you can definitely use a little bit hotter setting. Outside corner, you just don't need quite the heat. After this cools, I'm going to cut it in two places. One, we're going to see what it did on the colder settings on the outside corner, and then the other, the hotter settings. I won't show you the actual cutting and the polishing because we've been through all that before. But the one on the right is the hotter on the outside corner. And the thing I'm interested in seeing is, does the penetration meet? Well, does the penetration from one side kind of overlap the penetration from the other? The more you polish, the more detail you generally see. I took these down to about a 400 grit polish so you can see some details. You can see those lines in there, which are something apparently called solidification segregation. And you generally don't want to see straight lines. So when I first saw this on the first one that I did a few years ago, I thought it might be a lamination, but I got a comment from a steelmaker metallurgist who cleared me up on that. Well, I learned something doing this video. I hope you did too. Thanks for watching. And I hope you'll visit my online store at weldmonger.com. That's how I pay for these videos. See you next time.